I've graded the writing of perhaps 5,000 students in my career, and what I've realized is that people make many more mistakes in punctuation than they do in grammar and usage. And the one punctuation mark that causes the most problems is the comma. It's a really subtle, flexible, extremely valuable punctuation mark, but people tend to use too many of them or too few of them, partly because we think we should punctuate wherever we pause if we were speaking, and that's often true, but that's not the whole rule, and it gets people into trouble. So the main rule I'm going to give you, the one that I would call the prime directive for using commas, the most useful for almost every situation, is this. Main clause is a useful one. It's also known as an independent clause, and it consists of a subject and a verb, and sometimes an object, that expresses a complete idea. If you can identify the main clause in a sentence, you're on your way to punctuating correctly with commas, and here are some examples. I'll give the illustrations first, and then the rule. So here's a quote by Mark Twain. When in doubt, comma, tell the truth. In that one, tell the truth is a main clause. It implies the speaker, you have the verb, and you have an object, and so the rule is going to be separate that main clause from the other words that precede it or follow it. The next one, a quote from Woody Allen. For the first year of our marriage, comma, I tended to place my wife underneath a pedestal. In that one, I tended to place my wife underneath a pedestal. That's the main clause. It's a complete sentence, a complete idea in itself. And so you separate out for the first year of our marriage by a comma. Stephen Colbert, if you're laughing, comma, I defy you to be afraid. In that one, I defy you to be afraid, is the complete sentence, the main clause. So you separate if you're laughing by a comma. It's not the whole rule, but it's the start. The main rule for setting off commas from independent clauses, use a comma if it does two things at the same time. One, it sets off the main clause from the other elements of the sentence. And two, it marks a point where you would pause when speaking out loud. If it does only one of those, you probably don't want to use a comma.